operator group. So the programs must be redesigned, the policies must be reoriented, and the process must be better evaluated in a different way, where the tribal needs must be given. Again, we have to go back to the tribal consortium, that the tribal needs must be re-identified. Still, by planning in a room like this cannot be sufficient for the tribals. They must be tribals categorically. That means an egalitarian approach has to be taken. That means a specific tribe has got specific problems, has got specific social beliefs, has got social specific taboos. That has to be identified, and the policies must be reoriented in that direction. So that which I want to say, then I'd like to request to thank you all.
Topic in the MPL dissertation, but unfortunately for 1 or 2 days delay, he could not be awarded degree. So he has completed MPL during due to delay in submission. Then I told, and Dr. Babu told, don't be harassed, you have already done half of the work, complete your PhD. By that time he has already registered on for PhD. So he has taken much pain in collecting information from the villages. One advantage he has, he is fluent in Kui language, Konga language. So that is the added advantage for by which he could be nearer to the people and collect the basic data. And even we persuaded him to go to Nachikalinga, Gananath Patra. We took him there. With much hesitation he went there, but he was benefited. After meeting Nachikalinga, he could know what was the reason for his movement, how he was exploited. And he has added one section here, Chasimulya Adivasi Sangha, their problems, and how, what shape it has taken, it is also incorporated in this. As he has told, that the old type of exploitation is not so much there. It has taken new shape, but exploitation is there. Of course, earlier, the Kandhas were mainly exploited by dumb exploiters, wine vendors, sundis, saukas, money lenders, mostly belonging to non-tribal sections. This type of exploitation has come down to a great extent, what we have found in his work. Due to implementation of several rules, laws, the exploitation of the previous type has come down. But the new type of exploitation has emerged. Even the PRI members, elected members, representatives of their own people, they don't hesitate to exploit their own people to provide Indira Avas Yojana or old age pension or a BPL card. Wherever there is an opportunity, he has taken some case studies here. How their own people have been are now exploiting the tribals. This has taken new set. So main thing is, where there is a class division, haves, have-nots, powerful, powerless. So there is always a tendency that powerful or haves will dominate over the have-nots of the poor. So this type of tendency is going on. So as he has told, unless these people are properly educated, awareness level develops properly, then this process will go on. There is, as he told, narrated, that there is a vicious circle. Poverty leads to exploitation, exploitation leads to poverty. So there is this type of vicious circle. This should be broken. So anyway, we congratulate him for his painstaking work. And as he told, Dr. Mahapatra has helped him a lot. Though I am the guide, but he was the main inspirer. It was due to his inspiration, constant scolding, so to say, he could be able to complete this work. And I will give credit to his elder sister, who is advocate in High Court and ex-chairman, chairperson of Jaipur Municipality. She must have rang me many times, several times, sir, see that he completes the thesis, because he is very lazy. He needs scolding. Unless you scold him, he will not do the work. Anyway, he completed the work. Now, he has taken, again he has taken admission in MPhil. See that he is doing MPhil, dissertation will be on folklore of Konga people. So, on behalf of myself and on behalf of all of you and court staff, I congratulate him for completing this thesis. Thank you.
He is presiding. Sir is presiding.